first thing that I recommend doing once you get your mount is take a look at the tripod here and examine the surface where the top of the tripod mates with the bottom of your mount. If the paint is rough and thick, as is the case with the Celestron CGEM, get yourself a Dremel or borrow one from somebody else and make sure you find the attachment head that looks like this. It's a buffer wheel of some sort. This works really, really well on stripping off the paint from the surface here. This rough paint, coupled with the rough paint at the bottom of your mount, makes it very, very difficult for you to do azimuth adjustments when you're doing a polar alignment. So I stripped all of my paint off using the Dremel, and then I replaced it with Teflon tape that I found online from Granger. It's about $50 for this roll, but I also got about 50 feet of it. It was enough to do my mount twice. I restripped it off and put it back on after I realized I screwed it up. And then I did a friend's mount as well after I knew the proper way to do this. So I'm going to show you the top of my tripod now, and you can see how I patterned the Teflon-based tape on this inner ring here. And this creates a very, very smooth surface for the CGEM mount to move in azimuth as I make adjustments. There's no high-pitched screeching, it doesn't stick, and makes fine adjustments very doable. You're also going to want to examine your mount itself. The bottom of the mount is going to have a lot of paint on it, and this inner ring right here is what we're most concerned about. The Teflon that I showed you on the top of the tripod mates with this surface here. We're going to go ahead and strip the paint off of that, something I have been meaning to do but never had a chance to do, and I thought that this video series would be an opportune time to take care of that. Go ahead and strip all the paint off these raised areas here. You don't have to worry about getting this inner recess that doesn't come in contact with anything on the top of the tripod if you have a Celestron CGEM. So you can see I've got my mount set up here, getting ready to strip that paint off. This mount came from China, and there have been many reports over the last few years of paints in baby cribs and other stuff like that containing toxic chemicals such as lead and arsenic. So, I can't stress this enough, I like to live. Make sure you have eye and breathing protection. You don't know what's in this paint. So hopefully now you get the point. can see a lot of nice shiny chrome now. So now that we've got the paint stripped off the bottom of the mount, we're ready to apply some of that Teflon tape I was talking about earlier. What we're going to do is apply it to most of these surfaces here. Again, we're not too worried about this recessed area. There's not a lot of contact that goes on in there. But we do want to get some Teflon tape on some of these silver areas here. To do that, all we really need are some scissors and a box cutter. First thing I want to do is just cut a really small piece of this tape off. These ledges here aren't that deep, and I'm not too concerned about getting 100% coverage, just 90% coverage. Just push it on just like that. We'll worry about trimming all the edges with the box cutter in just a few minutes. So now that I have all the paint stripped off the top of the tripod and the bottom of the mount, and Teflon tape in place, I'd like to show you how easy this is to move. The nut down here at the bottom is what adjusts how tight these two are sandwiched together. And as you can see, I've got this about as tight as I can go. And yet, it still turns. By eliminating all of that friction in between here, you can have this locked down as tight as you can get it, and you can still make fine adjustments in azimuth when you're doing your all-star polar alignment routines, which I'm going to show you later on.